JRWOX.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you, Nigerians. Happy birthday to you. I want to ask, how old are you now, Nigerians? How old are you now, Nigeria? How old are you, Nigeria? How old are you now? My greeting to His Excellency, the President of Federal Republic of Nigeria, to all the cabinets, want to say happy birthday to National Assembly, the lower house, to the upper house, to all the state governors, want to say happy birthday to you. I want to say happy birthday to good Nigerians. Happy birthday to you all. Thank you very much. The last discussion we had on this very station talked about knowing what the hand is having for you, knowing what the hand is holding for you. Now we want to further on. We want to further on talking about the spirituality of humans. How human can live an efficient life. Spirituality has been misunderstood by so many people before now. A lot of people have misunderstood spirituality to secretiveness. The title for today's message is Spirituality and Individuality. It is not collective responsibility. It is individuality's responsibility to be spiritual. I gave some analysis somewhere sometimes ago on the different life we are living as humans. Just like I've given the description of the importance of knowledge and the mind that we are operating on earth, the most essential thing for us to know is the world we belong. Spirituality and individuality. We might be in the same world, but we are not in the same world. Everybody belongs to a world. Maybe time will permit me to talk further on the categories of world we have on earth. So we got 7 different type of worlds on this planet earth. When you're talking about world, there is difference between the geographical world and the spiritual world. So now we might be in the same place, but not in the same realm. We have places we dwell as individual. We are residing in the same world, but not in the same realm. Everybody has a realm he or she belongs. I've given the description about heaven before, because when people talk about heaven, they refer to the upper heaven as the only heaven. In the Holy Scriptures, there will always be a reference to heaven that means the upper heaven, and as well means spiritual heaven. The upper heaven is heaven beyond the surface. You can descend and ascend to the upper heaven because it's beyond the surface. It's the heaven you can envisage through physical eye. Then we have inner heaven. We call it spiritual heaven. It will be very difficult to understand what I'm saying with literal mind. Spirituality is operating in a deep sense. The literal mind is limited. It's limited to what you can study with your head knowledge. Spiritual mind is deeper. So from this moment, I urge you to be in spirit so that you can understand everything I will be delivering to you today. Thank you very much. So we want to share our appreciation to Ayola Foods Limited, who has been by us, who has been supporting our program since the beginning of this very program on air. And I want to tell you, our viewers, that we are just celebrating a year on a TV station. We want to give glory to God. It's completed a year we have been on air, offering and delivering messages, as well as entertaining your lovely viewers at home on different stations. We want to say thank you for keeping it up with us. We'll not disappoint you. We'll continue to be here. Thank you very much. I want to show my appreciation to my daddy, Daddy Apo Rotimi. Mommy Apo, you are a wonderful family. We love you. We love your family. We love your children. We love everybody around you. We want you to keep it up for the nation. Today, there's going to be special messages given to our country, because our country is celebrating birthday right now. So we got no option than to wish our country, our nation Nigeria, a happy birthday. And the people of Nigeria, we want to say to you, happy birthday. Like we have sung, we want to say happy birthday to all our viewers in Nigeria, and we also wish other countries can wish us happy birthday. Nigeria is surviving, so we should give glory to God. Nigeria is surviving, we should give glory to God. It is not ordinary. Good Nigerians, we see the end of the road of their challenge. I'm so sure you're going to be hearing something that might look strange to you, but that is the truth. Like we have talked about the upper heaven, so there is going to be upper truth today. So I want you to be attentive very well. You're going to be hearing some strange things. And we also have an insight for Nigeria or Nigerians. We have an insight for you as a good Nigerian, what you should be expecting and what the sign of the time reads to us. We want to tell you what should be expected, what we should be expecting in the new year the Nigeria is going to, and the subsequent years ahead. We want to show you the sign of the time in Nigeria. So Nigeria will soon get rid of their challenge. The challenge is divine, though it's supernatural. It's beyond natural challenge, but it's divine. God knows about it. He will know better as we move further in our message today. God bless you. Thank you. Like I've said before, the words I speak, they are not from a literal sense. They are from spiritual sense. The literal mind will not be able to comprehend what we'll be disclosing in the passage of the spirituality today. You need a spiritual mind. So you got to be in spirit. You must be very attentive. I want you to expect unusual today from the point I'm going to be rendering about spirituality. It's not going to be very deep for the sake of the generality. It's going to be a bit surface, but they are strange words. They are strange words in the sense that you have not used to them. So expect unusual. So if you do expect unusual, you know you need to pick your pen and your book, write, jot my points down. I was so impressed at somewhere last week when somebody important, very important to me, was showing me all the points I render on TV, and you know, it looks strange to me, all the points without missing any point. This important person, she was showing me in his jotter, see all the points you render, see they are transformational points, let's carry it up. I was so encouraged. So please, so that when you meet me somewhere, you can tell me my point. You can tell me what you have learned from me. You can even say it just the way I said it. And make your comment to me. Make your comment to me. Ask me any question. It is by God's wisdom we function. It is not by our own. And God is supernatural. Now, like I've said before, that we don't function with our own knowledge. We function with the knowledge of the spirit, spiritual knowledge. So, and we have seen the lapses. We try to resolve it through many ways, through many senses. But we have just found out that there won't be a permanent solution to what we are after if we don't address them from the spiritual realm. If we don't go back to our source is spirit. So if we don't consult our spirit to assess what is wrong in the spirit before it manifests physically, we may not get rid of our challenges permanently. So we got to make a journey, got to embark on a journey to ensure we got the right information from the spiritual realm to deliver to the world. And the most sensitive ones, we appreciate it better. So we are here to talk to most sensitive one. Your attentiveness is important. Now we have found out in life that there are lots in living that do not understand what it means by being spiritual. We have found out that a lot of people are just living life they don't understand. If you have been following me before now, you understand that there are many in living that don't know anything about spirit. So there are many in living that don't understand the stuff they are made of. Neither do they understand what is functioning in them. Your spiritual state will determine your physical state. Expect sickness when you are spiritually sick. The nation today are sick because people are spiritually sick. If the government of any nation is bad, it's because the people of that nation are bad. Bad system will rule over a bad people. Good people will change a bad system for better. It will be very difficult to get better with what is better that we are not getting better with. Every product of a nation is a product to mindset. Our mind gains strength from the strength in the spirit. If we can assess ourselves further than this, we will go further than this. Self-analysis makes a living truthfulness. A living truthfulness will make a living fruitfulness. A truthful man will be 100% a fruitful man. Our appearance is nothing to our maker. Our exterior means less to him. There is nothing that is something to God. Everything is a subject to his approval, to his sanction, and to his authorization. Our spirit as a nation, our spirit as an individual is something to God. God values our spirit, and there is nothing that is a secret to him. Spirituality is a secret of living. You know no secret outside what your spirit knows. Every secret is eating in the spirit. Nothing has a standard from physical realm. All grow from spirituality to reality. You cannot get better physically if you are not spiritual. Your visible betterment will spring from your spiritual growth. It is more significant to be real spiritually than the physical. Everything visible can be deceptive. The reality of a man is in his spirit. I mean, it will be very difficult for a man to have a lasting success when he has not succeeded in the spirit. It is in the law of being that a man cannot succeed physically if he has not succeeded spiritually. Our true life is based on our spiritual life. Pretension is out of carnality. Originality is out of spirituality. Everything listens to the voice you have not heard. We are talking about the power that controls the earth that you don't know. This power is behind everything functioning on earth. I mean, everything meaningful on this earth is under the control of this force. Reasons, races, bad, good, humans, animals are all under the subject of this power. This power dwells in the realm of invisibility. I mean the realm above the rest. When you are on the path of this force, it makes you powerful. You cannot be powerful outside the influence of this power. I mean outside the influence of your spirit. It makes you powerful when you're on its path. You cannot be made outside its making. It is not in the realm of physicality. It is not in the realm of unseen. We only practice what we sense from that realm. As a nation, we can be better when we are spiritual. As an individual, you can be the best, you can get the best when you walk with your spirit. Nigeria can be the best of our dream if the people can understand the spirit behind the living of this country. I believe the good Nigerians will be interested to know what will make this nation better. The only thing that can move your country forward as a good Nigerian will be found in the spiritual living secret of your nation. Your nation has a living secret, and the only thing that can move your nation forward as a good Nigerian will be found in the spiritual living secret of your nation. Nigeria cannot get better when our true people are carnal. When our priority appreciates carnality than spirituality. When our people dislodge the opportunity in their oneness, when their majority cannot see anything good in their differences,
when the intention to make money is cogent than making the nation. When self-elevation is expected than nation's consideration. When the youth are abandoned in the process of making the nations, they will end up taking over from their leader. Then the reverse will be the case. But there will be less to this challenge when people can live more in the spirit than in the physical. If spiritual sense can be appreciated than literary sense, if creativity can be more encouraged in our activities, then there will be less to this challenge. If Nigerians can just think straight, right, and positive, then there will be less to our challenges. Nigeria will be better if the sense of judgment is highly esteemed. If a true Nigerian listens to this sign of the time, understand that the hand of the Lord is strong on this time to purge the earth out of his fitness. God is about to separate bad people from good people in the nations. Nigeria is more pressed today is because Nigeria is the next world focus. So expect Nigeria to be much more purged than the nations of the world. And mind you, the purification of Nigeria will be faster than expected. The purification of Nigeria will be faster than expected. Mark my word. Come.